Hi, it's Dr. Nemechek, the Nemechek Protocol in Buckeye, Arizona, and I want to talk to you about thyroid and cortisol testing and how things kind of get thrown off here. Now, typically, these are being done for patients who are kind of fatigued, tired, you know, no energy, whatever term you want to put to it. And the testing is misinterpreted and often mistreated. So first, I'd like to talk about thyroid function. So thyroid function in internal medicine is one of the easiest things for us to manage. I could take a halfway intelligent person and teach them how to manage thyroid function in about an hour, all right? And so it comes down to this. In my 30 plus years of practicing medicine, I really only need to use the TSH level, thyroid stimulating hormone. That's a hormone coming from your brain and out to tell your thyroid how much to make. It tells us what the body's own interpretation is of, am I getting enough thyroid hormone? Okay. Now, excluding, this is produced by the pituitary gland. So we're going to exclude people with pituitary tumors or surgery, all right? Those are super rare cases, you know, less than 1 in 1,000 probably, and who have thyroid problems. So everybody else, really, you just look at the TSH. It's the body telling you if you need more or less. Now, what happens here is doctors are looking at these thyroid function tests, these other tests like the T3 uptake, the free T4, blah, 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 these other kind of tests. And you'll have a normal TSH. They got some slightly lowish T3 or T4 level, and they're giving you thyroid hormone. They're giving you, you know, thyroid hormone can be a T4, which is levothyroxine or Synthroid type of stuff, or Nature Armor, or it can be a T3, which is like Cytomel. And they're trying to make all these numbers normal. You don't need to do that. You just look at the TSH. Now, here's the problem. When the TSH is normal, these doctors don't know what else to look for. When a patient's fatigued, it is a huge list of problems you have to understand medically in order to help work through them. There's more than just iron, thyroid, depression, and cortisol. And you see these doctors and they just get stuck in this loop without trying to figure out other things. Now, what are some of those other things? Autonomic dysfunction is one, especially when your lab tests are all normal, your heart's normal, you know, your basic stuff is normal, because most of you have all seen these other doctors and they can't find anything. Now, some people will say, well, my doctor gave me this thyroid hormone and I felt better. Well, it's a super potent stimulus. Just because you give somebody something and they feel better doesn't prove that's what they needed. Now, in my kind of snarky way with patients, I'll sometimes say, you know, you could have somebody who's tired because they need iron because they're anemic, but if you give them a little bit of methamphetamine, they'll feel better. It does not prove they need methamphetamine. They need iron. You need to fix the real problem. And it's just complicated. Now, so you just look at the TSH. If that TSH is near normal, you move on, you look for something else causing the fatigue. The TSH, as it gets higher, that means you have lower thyroid function. We, in internal medicine, the general rule is we don't even treat somebody till they're over 10. The upper normal is like 5.5. And that's because between 5.5 and 10, nobody feels better. It doesn't do anything for them. So there are these certain rules, but mainly if your TSH is normal, don't take thyroid hormone. You got to move on and keep searching for your fatigue. Cortisol levels, okay? There really is no such thing as adrenal fatigue, okay? Your adrenal glands either meet your needs or they don't. And when they don't, in medicine we call it adrenal crisis. It's like catastrophic. You get a little bit of stress from, say, a bad sinus infection, and you are basically laying out and the paramedics are trying to give you fluid support because your blood pressure is so low and you're hospitalized. It's a traumatic thing. It's not some mild little kind of thing, okay? And But people say, well, we did this test and we spit in this thing and they measured my cortisol. Those tests are not very accurate, folks. Okay? They do not represent adrenal function. The way to do that is you have to have what's called an ACTH stimulation test. And they're hard to come by anymore because the dang companies who make ACTH have jacked the price up from like $20 to like $500 a shot now. And we used to do this all the time in my patients, okay, when I was an AIDS specialist. So there's very, very limited adrenal problems. It's called adrenal insufficiency. And when you have and that's measured by an ACTH stim test. And when you have trouble, it's an adrenal crisis in every sense of what the word crisis means. And for the thyroid, you just measure your TSH. Okay, if your TSH is normal and somebody thinks you need to have some thyroid hormone, I would go see an endocrinologist and get another opinion, because otherwise, A, you're going to get thyroid hormone you don't need, and that's going to really just actually make you hyperthyroid and can do things like cause problems with your heart or your bones, okay? And B, the real cause of your fatigue won't be addressed, all right? And a big clue is if your heart's pumping fine, and your basic chemistries, your blood counts, and things are all normal, you gotta start looking at your autonomic nervous system. It's a huge cause of chronic fatigue. All right, I'll get off my soapbox now. Everybody have a great week, and this is Dr. Nemechek in Buckeye, Arizona. Take care.